to the final race of this fantastic event here at Milton Keynes. All right, a final four-wheel drive, leg number three coming up. Michael Orlowski does not go in this one. He's chosen not to go as he's already wrapped up the victory. So Michael won two-wheel drive yesterday. And he's won the four-wheel drive today. Full domination. TQ in all five rounds of qualifying. And winning legs one and two. So Michael does not go in leg three. So Bruno Coelho will be car two leading him away. Marcus Kerr up will be going after him in second. Then it'll be Tommy Hall. Then it'll be Brock Champlin. So the grid is already. The marshals are in position. This is the final race of the day, final race of the weekend of this awesome event here at Milton Keynes. Still got spectators around the track from the shopping mall. Shops are closed, but these guys and girls do not want to go home. They're watching the race. Here we go, the final leg three coming up. And away we go. Bruno Coelho leads off from Marcus Kerr. Tommy Hall, Brock Champlin, Bartek Zalewski. Mistake there from Kerr, so drops him back a little bit. But he's got some serious pace in that car, as we've seen throughout qualifying and the finals today. Bruno Coelho sets off. He really wants the victory in this leg three. Podium position still up for grabs. Same as the trucks, the podium position for second and third is still up for grabs. Marcus Kerr had 2 seconds behind Michael Orlowski. Bruno Coelho has had a three, so he needs the win in this one. If Marcus is there for second, Bruno needs the one. They'll be tied on points. So Bruno Coelho leads round by 7 tenths of a second from Marcus Kerr up. Tommy Hall and Brock Champlin right there as well. So top four breaking away from the rest of the field. 1 minute quickly down in this A final, leg number three. Bruno's lead was 7 tenths of a second. Bruno gets a little bit wrong coming up the big jump in front of the driver's stand, so it's cost him a few tenths. So Bruno Coelho to the double. Marcus Kerr really pushing on. That gap's going to be coming down from 7 tenths of a second. More like probably half a second now, I would say. But we'll check them off as they go around this time. So here goes Bruno Coelho. Here comes Kerr up. And the gap is exactly half a second. So Brock Champlin then running third, Tommy Hall fourth. Nothing in between those two. You might just see those in the background on the camera, but we follow the leaders. We're following the leaders. It's all about the podium positions. Marcus Ormo gets it wrong. He managed to just save it on the tabletop there. Bruno Coelho still leading for Marcus Kerr up. Brock Champlin and Tommy Hall are pushing themselves along to catch the leaders. Daniel Kovic not too far behind there in fifth as well, just off camera. So Bruno Coelho goes through. 19.8 for Bruno. 20.1 for Kerr. 20.1 for Brock. 20.0 for Tommy Hall. So Marcus Kerr getting on with it now. He's chasing after Bruno. Halfway through this A final, leg number three already. Marcus Kerr, you can visually see the gap coming down. 19.7 for Kerr, 20.1 for Bruno. So the gap's down to 3 tenths of a second. Onto the straight they go, absolutely nothing in it. Brock Champlin still third. He's got away now from Tommy Hall slightly as Tommy's made a mistake. So can Champlin do anything about these two? I think they're too far ahead of him without a mistake. 3 tenths of a second, still the gap. These two matching laps last time through. Bruno Coelho and Marcus Kerr up onto the straight once again. 2 minutes to go. Here comes Bruno. They're coming around so fast to get onto another lap. Over the tabletop they go. Nice landing. Big air there from Kerr up. Nose was up. And Brock Champlin, you'll say, oh, Kerr's over, Kerr's made a mistake, so Bruno got breathing space, and it's Brock Champlin now to the two spot. Tommy Hall third, Marcus down to fourth, Kobovic five. So Bruno Coelho coming through to start another lap. Healy's Brock Champlin by 1.3. Over the double goes Bruno. 1 minute 20 remaining. Onto the straight goes Bruno Coelho. Bruno leads. It was 1.3. Brock Champlin is closing in on Bruno. And the gap's down to 8/10 of a second. Brock Champlin, 19.8, takes half a second out of Bruno's lead last time through. So 1 minute remaining of this A final leg three. Brock just makes a little bobble getting onto the straight, cost him a few tenths. So Bruno Quayle goes through. Here comes Champlin. And Tommy Hall running in third position. 1.6 second lead for Bruno Quayle. 35 seconds left on the master clock. Almost a length of the straight lead now for Quayle over Champlin. Tommy Hall still there in third. Not sure what this is going to do for the podium. We'll check it after the race when the computer works it all out for us. We're just watching it live as it happens now. 17 seconds left on the clock. They're going to go this lap and one more lap for the leaders. Here comes Bruno Quayle. He will start the final lap of this event now. Through goes Brock Champlin. 0.9 is the gap. Champlin 19.6, new hot lap. Bruno 19.9. So I think Quayle's got enough in his pocket. Just got to keep it rubber side down. Here he comes, backs off the gas nice and steady to the finish. And Bruno Quayle taking leg number three. Brock Champlin second. 7/10 of a second the gap. Tommy Hall third. Marcus Kerr up fourth. Johnny Skidmore five. So your overall podium is Michael Orlowski as the winner. It comes down to the tie break for second. And it's Bruno Quayle taking second. So he's the runner-up. Marcus Kerr up is your third place on the podium. Bruno Quayle! Very little in it between Bruno and Marcus on the tiebreak times. 7/100 of a second, making the difference between second and third. Brock Champlin with fourth, Tommy Hall fifth, Daniel Kovic sixth, Bartek Zalewski seventh, Johnny Skinmore eighth, Neil Craig ninth, Jamie Hall tenth, and Misha Vidmeyer in 11th. So that is the wrap and an end to the racing action here at Milton Keynes for the GP 2023. Thank you all for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed our coverage. We'll see you again at some more race events very soon. Thank you all, and we are signing off.